Hello and welcome to Watermer channel. I'll continue playing Factorio. In this episode I'm thinking about preparing for nuclear power. For nuclear reactor I'll need copper plates, steel plates, a lot of advanced circuit, and concrete. For heat exchanger we should have everything we need, as well as for steam turbine, so only concrete and advanced circuits. Let's see what we need for concrete. 1 iron ore, 5 stone bricks and 100 water. We have stone bricks here. I have water here, so now I only need iron ore. So maybe I'll just fill storage chest with the iron ore and I'll build a assembling machine somewhere here. I'll need one more assembling machine. I also need iron plates. So let's try to get that. I'll need one assembling machine. I'll need 500 concrete. So that's a lot. But nuclear energy should be somewhere near pollution free and it should produce a lot of energy. So we have bricks here. Could just build that assembling machine somewhere here. Is this drill mining anything? No, it doesn't have any resources as well as this one. So let's add this mining drill somewhere here to get all possible stone. And now I can build. I deleted the wrong assembly machine. Let's set it for walls. And now I can build assembling machine for concrete over here. Let's set it on concrete. We'll need stone bricks as well as water. And now only iron ore. And I will need 500 iron ore here. And I will offload concrete to this storage box here. But no, it produces 10 times concrete, so I'll only need 50 iron ore. So that's not a lot. as I have imagined. Let's see if a train is still here. Let's try to get some more iron ore or concrete. We have too much iron plates, at least. Everything is working. I need electronics in this chest. Let's see where we are producing electronics. Over here. We don't have enough electricity, I suppose. Yeah. And why is that? Because I don't have enough coal. This should fix a problem. This assembly machine should produce electronic circuits. But it needs copper cables, and copper cables are being produced there, so I'll need another copper cable production. I will build it somewhere here. And now I can move copper. Or copper cable production. That should be good for now. And labs are again working. Let's take some advanced circuits. Because we'll need 500 of them. Do you have enough oil? Yes. Storage is up full. Let's install efficiency modules in oil refineries. Electronic circuit protection, but I need more copper cables. I can build another assembly machine for copper cables here, but I need copper. And you don't have copper because one drill is out of copper ore. That should fix a problem. Let's add one more electric furnace and two more electric mining drills for copper plates. And now the drills. Let's see if that will be enough. I don't have maximum electricity. I need to fix that soon. And with this night vision goggle, the nighttime is like a daytime, so it's hard to determine if we have enough electricity or not. A nuclear reactor, nuclear power is researched, so I can go with lubricant. Thank you. Let's fill the boilers with coal manually for now. Now we meet the electricity requirements. I will need fast inserter. Here. And another assembly machine for copper wires. But again, I can't place copper wires on the side. That should be enough. All the assembly machines producing advanced circuits are working. Lubricant is finished. We can lock electric engine, but let's go with mining productivity for now. Those two furnaces do not have efficiency modules, so I'll need two more of them. And during the nighttime, again, we don't have enough electricity. Steam turbine consumes steam, but boiler produces steam. Its output 60 units of steam per second. It uses the same. Its maximum output is 5.82 megawatts, and steam engine. So let's try to build one steam turbine. And let's see if it will work. It consumes steam, but produces the same amount as to steam engines, because temperature should be 500 as from nuclear reactor. So let's add one more boiler. Leave this steam turbine for now. Pollution is lower than required for spawners to be active, so that's good. And now I have 500 concrete. I only need more steel plates, more copper plates, and advanced circuits. We have a lot of steel plates, so that's good. I need copper plates. They are in this storage. And now only advanced circuits. I don't have enough conveyor belts. Or is it iron gear wheels? Conveyor belt should be somewhere here. and I don't produce enough. So I need more iron plates. I think I'll build fast underground builds here. We have a lot of iron ore, so that's good. All the furnaces are working at full capacity. And then I'll have 6 more conveyor belts. Now all the assembly machines are working. I think I'll add more furnaces. Five of them for now, so I'll need 5 efficiency modules. Iron ore somewhere here. 3 spaces for furnace, 1 for inserter, and conveyor belt should be here. I will need fast splitter. I build it here. Let's see if that will work. Then I will change conveyor belt like that. And now these furnaces will have iron ore as well. I'll change something here as well. I will add steel chests here and then move conveyor. Next to the crates. So inserters could fill crates even if the conveyor belt is full. I will delete that. I shouldn't have done this. It looks like I have enough iron plates for now. And the train goes back with almost full wagons. I will add more inserters to float. Iron ore here. I'll build two more furnaces. I'll need faster conveyor belts here. Gas furnaces are stopping. I'm putting iron plates on a conveyor belt. And we don't have enough iron plates here. Train is back with almost full wagons. Let's go and see. How's our iron ore mines doing? It is working at full speed, at least it looks like that. Fast underground belt as well. And mining productivity increased. We'll need two more new science packs to increase it furthermore. So maybe let's go with electric engine. these furnaces should be able to place iron plates on a conveyor belt. But we are running low of electricity. And now I can have robotics, which will unlock flying robot frame. Bodies of flying robots need to be specialized to do either logistic or construction tasks. That sounds interesting. As well as exoskeleton equipment. Inserted into armor to increase movement speed, you can equip multiple exoskeletons at once. Let's go with robotics. And I think we'll see what robotics are in the next episode, and I'll end this one here. So see you next time.